Do you guys see how the Asbury Motorsports guys are working together for the draft?
Yep.
Now the risk that adds is if the lead driver makes a mistake, then it can cost the second driver some time, but I think there's a lot of advantage to be had with the draft. Is that something that you guys would be willing to do together?
We've done it before. It's not as effective as it is in the ST cars, but it still works.
The one problem I can see us running into is the following car is obviously going to catch up and pass the lead car, so you guys would need to organize that so that when it happens, maybe the lead car just pulls over and brakes to get out of the way, and then now that the previously following car, now that he's in the lead, he finishes his lap, and that's the record lap. Then the following car is now the target car to set a hot lap.
The only problem is with qualifying on these titles, only the first lap is the golden lap. So we literally only have two good opportunities to do it in this session.
Yeah, that's a good point too. But with draft, that might be able to overcome tire disadvantages.
We'll see pit stall, because we're at the very front.
Another thing I would recommend is just during quali, if you two could set your team speak so that it's voice activated rather than button activated, that way you can talk in real time so that, you know, you might be in the middle of a corner and you're getting close and you want to tell the front guy to go ahead and move out of the way or something. Okay. Gotcha. If we're, when we're doing quali, I'll stay quiet. And then if you would like a quiet period, just request it on the radio. And then that way we'll all know. That's dedication.
Minutes remain in FT qualifying. 5 minutes.
Okay, Auntie, did you get the setup and have it loaded? Okay, good.
I'm doing it. Sure.
Are you guys comfortable with each other's pace? I don't know how well you guys run together.
Yeah.
And then ideally on one of the straightaways, during like the the target. Yeah,
I'm thinking just get the draft down the first two straights, you know, down the main straight and then down the straight after turn three. That's the main straights are anyway. The draft isn't that effective beyond the first sector.
And then make sure to come.
But yeah, it's still a corner, though. It's not flat out.
Could not hear you well.
I'd rather not be behind someone going into that.
And then maybe after the kink is where you guys make the rotation. And then Amjed would finish his hot lap. And now he would become the leader, you could say, who's pushing the air out of the way. Thank you. Yeah.
Two minutes remain in ST qualifying. GS drivers, you may take to your cars, but do not exit your pit stalls.
Yeah, there's gonna be a wreck.
Auntie, where are you on pit lane?
You know, it's how you enter the server for practice. It doesn't change until the actual race.
GS, your qualifying is green. ST, your qualifying is checkered. Hot laps will count.
I'm stuck behind a bunch of cars.
Left side. Clear.
Ooh, that's interesting that the stone scrubbed that. Scrubbing up with Steve Brown.
Clear. Left side. Clear on the left. Car on your left. Clear. right side. Clear.
I might be able to do a couple more turns.
Car on your left. Clear on the left. Left the fuel in.
Anybody using this channel?
Yes, and I think Ante is in here too.
Okay, good. I just wanted to back up. Since I don't want to jump out of the sim, I wanted to make sure. Is it just you and, I'm sorry, is it just me and Julian and our car on TeamSpeak now? Because I'm not going to go check it.
I've got in-game chat muted because of yakking.
Yeah, I just went into the GS channel.
Yeah, go ahead, Ben.
No, not bad at all. Yeah, if you don't mind, I'm gonna take this next up alone. So I kind of on my lap, I went a little bit too fast going in. I think I may be able to pip out Scott Beck.
Also, keep in mind, Amjad, there's no I don't think there's any value in pushing hard on your outlap. You can go a little easy and keep the tires cool, and then push hard.
Left side, clear.
Radio silence, please. 9, blue to Canada. No. Yeah, game's over. Dan, I'm not worried about Skjoldbeck at all because he's going to hand the cough to Steve Brown.
Good to hear.
When you get in the car, you should be able to get Steve pretty easily.
I hope so, because Brian is extremely strong.
I'd say the one to worry about would be Torque Chicken with Bieri handing it off to Hansarenko.
Yeah, that's our competition.
One thing I forgot to mention in the driver's briefing, ST drivers, you will be switching sides. Again, ST drivers, you will be switching sides for the race start.
That's another way to talk to Gary. Oh, wait.
I heard he's really selfish and he might not even let you have the car for the second half. Okay.
Into his teammate too, right?
Amjad, as soon as you pull in, I'm going to load our race fuel, and I'm going to share that. So, Auntie, you can load that as well.
Okay, I'm heading over to the other channels to see you guys.
All right, good luck.
Okay, just shared. That way, if you pick the newest one, you don't have to worry about it. You'll know that it's right. You'll need 2 stops, full fuel each time. So full fuel, full tires each time. And if you have a, I'm gonna type this in the group chat too so that Amjad can report out on it later. 48 minutes remaining is the earliest you can take your final pit. That's probably the most important. Now, Auntie, how do you plan on making sure one of your pits...
And see how this turns out.
How are you going to make sure that
they clean, have fun, and remember, again, ST, you are switching sides.
At least one pit stop is 30 seconds long.
Those the pit timer that shows up on screen. You can use that.
Do you have a stopwatch?
Dan, you're going to need to get out of the garage for me to go it up.
Sorry about that.
I'm going to wait till the last second anyway, because we need every little bit of fuel.
I wouldn't push it too far. I've had that burn me before.
Yeah, I mean, it'll be like 15 seconds.
I would do 30.
30? Okay.
I already feel uncomfortable now that it's 45. All right, just get in. Okay. If you have a problem, you'll need time to change something to get back in, so.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, boy. Hopefully that doesn't interfere with your upload speed. All right.
One lap to
good
green.
Luck, everybody.
Line up on the right side. Pit road is closed.
Oh, that's awesome. I plan to have one in a couple years.
God, Phoenix ISP must be so awesome.
I plan on moving to Austin, Texas in a year or two, and they have Google Fiber there, so I'm looking forward to that.
Oh, speaking of Austin, Dan, are you going to be at COTA next month?
Am I going to be where?
At Circuit of the Americas for the WEC weekend.
What? I don't know.
World Endurance Championship. It's next month at Circuit of the Americas.
Well, I might have to.
Yeah. Hey, if you do, drop me a note because I'll be there.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, there's a bunch. You're in Texas Club now, right? So there's actually an info thread on the Texas Club forums.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll have to check that out.
Yeah, so did I. I did make the same mistake. I was like, what the heck is Jodbeck doing? It's like, oh, okay, yeah, that's right.
Alright, I guess the only thing that could screw up from here is make sure your pit boxes are checked for full fuel and tires. I think it defaults to that anyway.
Yeah, for me it does. You can double check too.
Yeah, and for you, I'll double check. Can you remind me what changes if I click become crew chief? That's not worthwhile, is it?
No, that's how you control my F-boxes.
Oh, okay. And then I uncheck it when I'm done. Gotcha.
Yes. You go back to the fire after the kink, correct?
There's no harm in doing it.
Yeah. I'll make sure that Mr. Bureaucrat West doesn't ding me for it.
Might want to type in the text chat now, mute drivers.
Yeah, I've already got them muted.
And mute all teams.
You got those two muted.
Get ready, going green. The pace car is in. Green, green, green.
Green, 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 FP.
Left side.
Marshall's dream noise was flat out long before the last corner. I think we can count that as a jump start, can't we?
Keep to the right. Keep to the right. Clear on the left. Car on your left. Clear on the left. Left side. Keep to the right. Clear on the left.
All that, not just in a second.
Right side. Clear on the right. Thank you.
velocity. Go for the safe fuel.
I would say fuel. I don't think you'll outrun him for long. You'll just go side by side and slow both of you down. If he makes a mistake, take the opportunity. But if it's just a small mistake, I would just stay behind him and just draft.
Copy.
Still there. Hold your line. Clear on the right.
I don't know, what happened to the e-car?
I think he had a wreck early on. He's been in pit lane for several laps.
I'm being careful now because I'm just now starting to lose the funds. It's not bad though, but I can feel it giving away.
Understood.
Thank you.
You guys are doing great. Just remember, if the guy in front of you makes a significant mistake, be prepared to pounce.
Car right. Clear.
Exactly.
That car's a lap down. Right side. Clear on the right.
My guess is a little bit tougher to break.
If you can follow a little more closely without overworking your tires, it will put more pressure on them.
Yep. Although my funds are pretty much gone at this point.
Understood. Eight more laps of fuel. I agree, I think he's done.
I don't think I can hang on to Brian anymore. I'm just hanging in there.
No worries. You did really well so far. You might even seize an opportunity if he gets hung up in traffic to catch back up to him. Then you're saving fuel better.
I don't have that luxury. But I've been doing about a half a gallon per lap.
Thank you.
Go ahead and take it, Christian.
Thanks, Kevin.
Left side. Clear. Right side. Keep to the left. Clear on the right. About 5 laps of fuel left.
Sorry.
Yep, these tiles are gone.
No worries, you only have about 3 to 4 laps before you're coming into pit.
Copy.
Yeah, you're doing one lap better on fuel economy, Auntie. Amjad, there's no point in saving fuel at this point, but after the pit, we'll want to do some more fuel saving.
Well, you're in the car after this stint anyway, Dan.
Go ahead and take it, Chris.
Oh, I am? Okay. I'm gonna go to the bathroom now.
Okay.
You're good.
Car on your left. Clear on the left. Car on your left. Clear on the left. Clear.
All right, once you get into third, can you keep it in third here, Amjad? Okay. I didn't notice that earlier, but I think that's part of your fuel consumption problem was going on to second for that corner, but oh well. This you can go to second, that's okay.
You could still make it another lap though.
Yeah, you're fine. If I would have caught that earlier, I think we might have been able to squeeze out another lap, but no biggie.
I doubt it, but it... Yeah.
Yeah, not that alone.
You got about 2 laps of fuel.
Yeah, same here.
Yes, that's why we're doing the Java swap right now.
I don't know though, Auntie, you're in the draft right now, and so if you make your slow stop now, you'll give up the draft. I like the idea of staying in the draft, because you don't know who you'll be with if you take the long one now. Ah, they're going side by side though. They might slow each other down.
All right, Dan, bring it home.
All right, all your pit boxes are ready to go. Alright, pit this time.
The lead is
make sure to
now.
Slow down in
that
time, you don't want to get a speed
down.
Penalty.
Car right, clear on the right.
Ooh, look at that time I made up on him.
That car's a lap down. Car right, clear on the right. Left side.
And as a reminder, I think everybody's going to be struggling for fuel this race. Judging by the fuel calcs, Amjad had quite a bit worse fuel usage than me, so we'll definitely be saving a lot.
The lead is pitting now.
I'm going in. All right, Amjad, per your fuel, it's 45 minutes remaining is the earliest, but by mine, it's 48, so...
Yeah, it's a good thing you're in the car now. I'll pull behind you.
Yeah, you too, bud.
You're in first.
All right, I'm Jed. After I finish about a half hour, can you run some fuel calcs?
Yeah, I'm on it.
Amjad, can you also calculate Antti's fuel economy based on his first pit stop?
I can't see his fuel though. Okay, that's helpful.
And another way to do it is you can just calculate a full tank. Divided by the time his stint was. Because it's mostly about gallons per minute.
That car, the left down. Car on your left. Clear.
Alright, do you know how many gallons per minute I've been using since I left the pits?
Yeah, look on that.
That car's a lap down. Left side, clear. That car's a lap down. Left side, clear. The car right. Clear on the right.
Any news on fuel economy? I'm thinking about just driving slow, saving, and letting Todd go by and then draft him.
I'm still working on it, so I'm sorry. so you just attack over 2/10 per minute.
That car's a left down. Car on your left. Clear.
So yeah, so right now your pace is at 47.5 minutes. That's our final pit stop.
So how many minutes are left? Will I make it on two?
Make it on two, it'd be 49.5 minutes.
So I need to save big time.
Yes, a little bit, yeah. Only a 1/10 of a gallon. But yeah. If these other guys are cooking her, then you have the advantage on if you can save.
Go ahead, Russell.
Second circuit.
Yeah, it's all good, man. Just save that fuel.
That's what I'm thinking. If my numbers were right, I have to do a lot of fuel saving for us to make it. Either that or I'm just a bad driver, I don't know.
Still there. Stay on the right, clear. That car's a lap down. The car on your left. Clear. Thank you.
Thank goodness. I feel like we're bleeding to death. Yeah, I just can't get any consistency with the field.
Oh, gentlemen.
Sorry.
That car's a lap down. Right side. Still there. Still there. Stay on the left. Clear on the right. That car's a lap down. Car on your left. Clear on the left.
You're doing good on your fuel safe. Keep it up.
Right side. Clear.
Is my laps per tank estimated better than yours?
Yes.
How much?
By a lot, Tedder. I'm having a hard time paying attention to your race because I'm doing numbers for Dan's race, but you're actually doing better on fuel than Dan
is right
now.
Fifth.
Just ever so slightly.
That car's a lap down. Right side. That car's a lap down. Clear on the right. The car right. Stay on the left. Clear on the right.
Do I have enough fuel to make it to 48 minutes remaining before pitting?
Yes.
You're back in fourth position.
We have 4.5 left of laps left on fuel.
That car's a lap down. Clear.
Don't worry about your earth boxes, I'll take care of it.
I've already set them where I want them.
You want to do a splashing dash?
I want to be prepared if I need a splashing dash.
You still need one more full pit stop.
Whoops, I forgot. Can you set it all
back
to full?
Yeah, I'll do it, man. Don't worry about it. I'll get it.
Got about 5 laps of fuel left.
Yep, that's him. Glutton Pot.
Alright, James, I wasn't sure if you're trying to give that to me or what. Sorry about
that. Yeah, I was gonna let you.
I think Steve just realized he won't make it on fuel. He's driving a lot slower now. I had to pass him because he was willing to let Todd run away, and I wanted to stay on Todd to save fuel.
Come on, Dick.
If you think I'm gonna let you pass in the kink, you're crazy.
this point, you're gonna have to pit in this time by. Because you got 1.7 laps left. Everyone's giving the same boat. We're gonna be short. Onto your best strategies is to go as long as you can and fill it up. Okay, you pit it in this time by pit in. Dan pit. Watch your speed.
The lead is pitting now.
Right now we're about 4.5 minutes short. We're gonna need a caution, so I just say just go for it.
What if I just save extremely?
I think you're gonna drop back too far. I don't think it's gonna work. You can try it if you want to.
Shoot. When I was chasing Todd, I was thinking, you know, I'm probably burning too much. Maybe he's got a 3-stop strategy.
Sorry, Rich.
lead is pitting now. You're backing second. Good job. The lead is pitting now.
How many laps do you estimate I'll still have to drive?
Yeah, I don't think saving works because you have to run 2 minute 45 laps. You have to be like 15 seconds off the pace to make it now.
I'm just pissed. This is a fuel economy race. This isn't even fun.
I know. My best advice is to stay on, Strodbeck's ass as much
You're
as you can.
You're in first. Good job.
Can't do it. He has one lap more of fuel than I do. How many laps do I have to run?
At least 20.
At 8, shit.
Dan, I can say just have fun, man. If you want to go at it, go at it. It doesn't matter to me.
No, I'm going to get second place and just cruise.
Okay.
Freaking transmission skips shifts like crazy, this build. How many laps do I need to still run to make it to the finish? Once we reach the 40-minute timer, we're going to need like 8.5 gallons left to make it.
Not going to be that bad.
Yeah, 8.3 is exactly how much we need based on my fuel run.
Thank you. With this fuel save, you can make it to the end. I can tell you that right now.
No, I can't. I've already run the numbers. I have my spreadsheet next to me. Although my spreadsheet is worst case scenario, a full lap after the timer runs out, but still.
Yeah, but you don't need 8 gallons to add. Oh, I see what you're saying.
Okay. I need 8 in the tank.
You need 8 in the tank, okay.
Alright, I reran the numbers. Half a lap after the timer stops. At 40 minutes, we need 8. 8 even. At 35, 7.07. I'm Jed, can you crunch that?
Oh, yeah.
Just type it into Google.
Sorry, what was it, Auntie?
That's how much fuel we need right now to make it.
30.2.
Oh, I'm so jealous. All right, when we get to 35 minutes, we're going to need 7 gallons. Can you crunch that to liters? Well, I guess we don't really need to because we already know Auntie has enough.
Yeah.
Auntie, I'd say you can probably go full speed because your fuel savings is already better than mine, and mine is what I used for the fuel calcs.
That car's a lap down.
looks like. Still sure. You said 7 gallons at 35 minutes?
Correct. Sounds still sure.
Car on your left. Clear.
Looks like I should have just done another stop.
Yeah. You can do what, Dan, you can do whatever you want. If you want.
It's too late now. It's too late now.
I don't care.
You're back in fourth position.
I just wish I would have crunched the numbers better at the beginning.
And I'm not in for points or anything. I mean, I'm just having fun. So if having fun means going out, falls out, be my guest.
No, I'm here to win. I'm staying left.
Car on your left. Still there. Hold your line. Clear on the left. That car's a lap down. You're back in third. Keep hustling.
Has to go slow that you can't keep up.
Well, and the other thing that's annoying is when I short shift too much, a wide open throttle upshift doesn't work. And it's ingrained in my head to always wide open throttle upshift, so I keep skipping all kinds of gears right now.
Right side. Clear on the right.
You got coast out. Hang on.
Yeah, I saw that. Number 38, do you need a tow?
Uh,
Yes, I do. Blue motor, sorry.
The yellow flag is out. Line up single file. Pit road is closed. Catch
oh, that's
the 82 car.
Could have just went balls to the wall. It's been in second place.
Yeah, we have our yellow flag due to a stuck car just off turn 5. Stuck car, go ahead and take your time. His car has deployed, entering turn 3.
Yeah, one of them was just pitting as the caution came out, I see. Antoine was pitting just as the caution came out. So he's okay. Does Dan need a push?
Did you hear what Dex said?
No, I have everything muted.
Okay, he said, does Dan need a push?
Yeah.
It wouldn't hurt. As a heads up to ST driver, if you pit before you complete a wave by we have granted you, the wave by is forfeited by iRacing. Recommended to complete your wave by before making your first pit stop. For all drivers who are aware, this is going to be a standard caution. Standard caution. Race car into Canada Corner. Be cautious when you're approaching the pit. Race essential only, please.
Pit road is now open.
Alright, I'll go ahead and rethrow this caution here in a second, and we can do the first guys.
One lap to green. Hang on, we're not going green, not going green. Hang on, we're not going green, not going green.
All right, Auntie, when we get out of yellow, it's gonna be a sprint to the finish. Everybody should have enough fuel. So who's going to dive bomb Brian? Yep.
All right, this first set of wait-bys is to get The ST car is tucked between the GS leader and the ST leader in their proper places. Hang on for more.
How should we organize it? Which one of us...
had the position when the yellow flag came
hey,
out.
MJ, can you look at our race laps and see who had a faster pace? Because I don't want us to have to battle back and forth, which could stop us from catching up with Brian, you know?
Looks like Auntie paces around the 231s, you know, low 231s.
Alright, we have no GS cars that are overly biased.
While you're able to do like 30 and a half of your stints.
Then the other question is, if I pass Auntie, am I fast enough to hang with the other guys anyway? I don't know.
Yeah, you can hang on with them.
Number 8-1, will you be pitting
the magic of the draft.
Well, the main thing I'm thinking is, what should we do right off the beginning? That way we don't waste any time figuring out who's faster.
So, I mean, if you guys...
Because if you're faster, then I'll just push you the whole time. But if I'm faster, then you can let me by right at the beginning, and
number
I'll put a strong attack
tell
on
me
them.
Or type or do something to indicate if you are pitting this time around.
At least that's what I'm thinking. What do you think? Would it be all right if I get a little bit of a run on you coming up on the green and pass you into turn one?
Last call.
Okay.
You can pass it for the timeline.
Or for the wave line.
Once,
eight,
once,
one,
the
crack
is talk. Once it goes green, you can pass.
Wave signals. Something.
Yes. Okay. Thank you for working with me.
Number 449, are you pitting this time around?
Nope. This is going to be a stupid long caution, by the way, because of trying to get the STR organized.
One lap to green.
Number 42, will you be pitting this time around?
Hang on, we're not going green, not going green. Hang on, we're not going green, not going green.
Well, we have two more laps and it takes 4 minutes to go around. So we're looking at the least 14 minutes left on the clock when we go back to green.
Pete, number 42, will you be pitting this time around? Last call, number 42. I think we're going to have a requisition of new headsets for everybody. Nobody can hear me. Number 42, are you pitting this time around?
I'd like to know what Todd's strategy was. I wonder if he was going to run
repeat,
out of 42. Fuel.
No, not pitting.
Thank you.
Because I could tell Brian was saving once we exited the pits. But Todd's
number
like
5, are you pitting this time around? Negative. If you can hear me. That's you 5x5, number 5x5.
Yeah, we hear you, 99. Hang on.
Let the 99 car by.
Repeat 99.
Right, drivers should be aware there will be this will be slightly extended due to the nature of the cars that are getting their way by.
Out of curiosity, what top speed are we hitting in this track?
Standby. Like about 135 ish going into Canada.
This thing does 78 in second gear, which means that our rear end ratio is like a 273 or a 331, the same as what the car got from the factory, which is just silly, silly tall gearing. This car would be a lot faster overall if we could swap the rear end to like a 410 gear ratio.
Hang
and if we
on,
did that,
green,
fifth gear
green.
Would top out
Hang on, we're not
around
going green,
140,
not going
150.
Green.
And if we're only hitting high 130s, then that would be a way better gear. And this car would actually be quite a bit, not a lot, but a bit faster.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so now we're looking at about 10 minute sprint.
Which means we only need
driver,
2 gallons.
Next time around will be one to go.
So now we have
next
too much fuel.
One to go.
Oh, the wonders of a CES yes race.
Heads up, drivers in the pace queue. You're right, we have two FP cars about to make their way through the field for their wave bys. Please let them through as quickly as possible.
Mustangs, keep right, please.
Let the 42 car by. Let the 55 car by.
Sorry, there was a bit of a checkup.
One lap to green.
All right, we're going to split the classes and get this thing rolling. We are 1 degree.
I'm gonna go radio silence. If you guys need anything, just say something. Otherwise, you got 10 minutes. Go at it. Good luck, boys.
Alright, FXY has let any Mustang through, which in this case is 7-5, and we're ready to go. Good luck, gentlemen. And don't forget, leader Tomoki, please leave a gap between you and the last GS car for the restart. Also, reminder, all cars are go on green.
The only thing I worry about is if Auntie lets me by on the inside, if that lets the guys behind me also by on the inside.
That's probably what's happening. If you want to do the pass, I suggest doing it on the outside, and Auntie gets brakes really hard on the inside going into turn one.
Okay.
Correct. Alright,
like
you guys are going back to green. I'm on radio silence. Good luck, boys.
Okay, I'll go outside.
Get ready. Going green. The pace car is in. Green flag, green flag. The next car's the leader.
If you get a run, go with it, go with it, go with it, go with it.
Car on your left. Still there. Keep to the right. Keep to the right. Still there. Hold your line. Clear on the left. Thank you. The next car's the leader. Car on your left. Still there, hold your line. Still there, hold your line. Stay on the right, clear on the left.
Damn, Dan, that was nice.
Both cars involved in that incident, you may tow.
We got the live potential caulking coming up. Stand by.
I don't need to know about any potential cautions.
No caution. Continue on.
Auntie, if I catch you, I'm gonna push you. As in a bump draft. Okay. Well, then if I get lucky, I'll slingshot. Thank you.
Alright, there's the checkered flag. Great job, you did really well.
Woo! Alright, catch you, Beth, guys. No respect.
Christian, I hope you had as much fun racing me as I had racing you.
Okay, the race is over. Bring it on in.
Alright, see everybody next time, September 12th, EIR. Just a little under a month to go for that race.
Ten out of ten parking job.
Well, it was good running with you guys.
Yeah, it was.
I wish we had a little bit more fuel, but otherwise, it was
fun. Yeah.
They were talking about it in the chat. It was, Steve said it was going to be close for them.
Sorry again, Anthony, man. That was pretty bad for you.
Oh, yeah, it was, but it's just one of those things that I know it's nothing intentional, so...
it kind of turned into one of those BS first guy races when usually there's a cock in the first 30 minutes of these races.
Yeah, I agree. That caution was not necessary. It was close enough to the gap.
VIR's next? Interesting. Dan, are you going to be around for VIR?
I'm going to go with a maybe,
yeah,
but I'd like
good
to.
Too.
I'll have to check my schedule.